Hello students, good evening. In this chapter I am going to explain about the 6th standard geography chapter 2, that is let us use the graticule. Okay, so first, what is meant by graticule? Graticule means what? So what are the lines, horizontal and vertical lines, okay, on the globe? So that will form like as a net. Okay, how net is like that? Okay, so that net, what are the horizontal and vertical lines on the globe? So that will look like as a net. So the another name of net is what? Graticule. Okay, so that's why it look like as a net, na? So that's why we call Earth also as a graticule. Okay, so see here they are showing globe to you. Okay, so in our school also available this globe. Okay, so what we call this? This is a globe. Okay, so globe means what? Model of the Earth. Okay, so you want more information about globe. Okay, so subscribe my channel and see one video I prepared about only globe explanation. Okay, you have to see that globe explanation, then you can understand very easily. Okay, what is meant by horizontal lines, what is meant by vertical lines, what is meant by equator. So everything I explained in that video, so you have to see that video. Okay, so before seeing this chapter, okay, so you have to see that video, then you can understand very easily this chapter. Okay, so coming to this chapter, so here observe the globe and answer the following. Okay, you have to observe the globe and answer the following questions. So what is the first question? What are the horizontal lines on the globe called? Okay, so here horizontal lines is there, na? So here horizontal lines, so these lines we call as a horizontal lines. Okay, so these lines we call as what? Horizontal lines. So these lines, what we call? Latitudes. Horizontal lines we call as latitudes, or it also called as a parallels. Okay. Second one, list the continents and oceans through which the equator passes. Okay. So see here 0 degrees line is there, na? So this is a equator. So this 0 degree lines, what we call? Equator. So this equator passes through which continents and which oceans? See here, so here 7 continents is there, na? So this is the Asia continent, this is Asia, this is Europe, and this is Africa, and this is North America and South America, Australia, and one more is Antarctica. Here Antarctica. Okay, here. So these are the continents. So equator passes through which continents? 2 continents. So what are that continents? South America as well as Africa. Okay, see here, South America as well as Africa. So these are the 2 continents. And which oceans, through which oceans equator passes? See here, so here Pacific Ocean is there and Atlantic Ocean is there. So through these 2 oceans equator is passing, and these two continents equator is passing. Okay, and here we have the 5 oceans. Okay, what is that 5 oceans? Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Arctic Ocean, next one is Southern Ocean, and next one is Antarctic Ocean. Okay, we have how many? 5 oceans is there and 7 continents is there. Okay, so I'll give one more video about continents and oceans also. Okay, next one, coming to the second question, coming to the third question. So coming to third question, encircle the intersection of 0 degrees meridian and 0 degrees parallel on the globe. Okay, so 0 degrees meridian means what? 0 degrees meridian. Already I told you, longitudes we also call as a meridians. Okay, longitudinals we call as a meridians, as well as it is also called as a what? Vertical lines. Okay, so here where this is this line is what? Here this line is 0 degrees prime meridian. Okay, and this line and equator, so this both where it is encircled, that means where it is meted. So this point, now, so here both the equator and the prime meridian meter, so you have to circle this place. Okay, so that is the answer, you have to circle that place. And next one, next question, what is the next question? See here, Which oceans are spread in all the four hemispheres? So which oceans are spread all the four hemisphere? So here we have the four hemispheres. So what is the part above the equator? So that part we call as a northern hemisphere. And what is the part below the equator? So that we call as a, this part we call as a southern hemisphere. And what is the part having this side of prime meridian? So this we call as a east hemisphere, eastern hemisphere, and this part we call as a western hemisphere. Okay, so here which oceans are flows throughout the four hemispheres? So this is the Pacific Ocean. So Pacific Ocean is flowing throughout the world. See, western side also it is flowing, as well as the eastern side also, as well as north also, as well as south also. Okay, and I like that. Next one is Atlantic Ocean also. See here, this one, Atlantic Ocean also passes through the four hemispheres, like eastern hemisphere, western hemisphere, northern hemisphere, and southern hemisphere. Okay, and next question. Which continents are spread in all the four hemispheres? So which continents are located in four hemispheres? See here. So this is the Africa continent. Okay, so this Africa continent, half part is northeastern side and half part is western side, and half part is in the north side, as well as half part is in the south side. So which continent is having the four hemispheres? Okay, so that is Africa continent. So our answer is what? Africa continent. Next one, at which two parallels do all the meridians coverage? Okay, so in which two parallels all the meridians are coverage? Okay, so that is 0 degrees parallel line. So what is that? 0 degrees parallel line. So that is the answer. Next one, when we talk about various places, regions, rivers, roads, etc., we are actually talking with reference to the earth. Okay, so anyone, we are talking about the any place or any region or rivers, roads. So we are talking reference to the earth. That means what? So that river is belongs to the west side and that region is belongs to the east side. Okay, so that means what? Based on the earth, we are discussing about that particular regions. The location of a place, the extent of region, and the extent of any linear feature can be described precisely with the help of parallel and meridians. Let us use how to use the graphical for this purpose. Okay, suppose you want to find out the any region. Okay, suppose where it is Delhi in India. Okay, so you want to find out how you can find out using the latitudes and longitudinals only. Okay, suppose you want to find the what is the length of Maharashtra state and what is the width of that. That means where it is started and where it is ended. So that area you want of Maharashtra state. So that purpose also we are using the parallels and meridians only. Okay, how it is useful for us? So let us see. Verify the following descriptions with the help of a world map or globe in the school. Okay, so when we are want to find out these are things, so for that we need a globe or we need a map. Okay, world map. Okay, while describing the location of place, we need to consider only one parallel and one meridian. Example, Delhi is located at 28 degrees 36 minutes 15 seconds north latitude and 77 degrees 12 minutes 13 seconds east longitude. Okay, so suppose you want to find out the only area or location where it is located. You want to find the location only where it is located. So for that purpose we are using the only one latitude and one longitude. That means one parallel line and one vertical line only we are using for the location purpose. Okay, so see here Delhi is located in where? In the 28 degrees 36 minutes 15 seconds north latitude. Here 36 here they are above 36 they are having the symbol now. So that symbol we are using for the minutes. Okay, and when we are using two symbols like this, so that is a seconds. Okay, and here when we are saying the direction, so that is a north, and if they are indicated with N, so that is a north direction. Okay, so here latitude means what? Parallel line. Parallel means horizontal line. Okay, horizontal line. Suppose see here, I'll show you. So this is the Asia continent. Okay, so what is this? This is Asia continent. Okay, so our country is located here. Our country is located in Asia continent only. Suppose Delhi is located here. Okay, so for that you want to find out the where it is located. So for that purpose you have to consider this parallel line, sorry, this vertical line and this parallel line. Okay, so this point where these parallel line and vertical line both are meeting in one point, so that point we call as the location of that particular place. So Delhi is located in this way. So what is the value of this vertical line and what is the value of this horizontal line? So that lines we call as a parallel and vertical lines. So this is the value of a parallel line and this is the value of a vertical line. Okay, next one. So what is this? What is this? This is a globe. Okay, this is globe. Also, it is also called as a, it is also called as a graticule. Okay, and they are given this into form in world map. This is a world map. Okay, next one. For description, describing the extent of region, we need to consider two parallels and two meridians at the extreme ends of the region. For example, the extent of Australia is described as 10 degrees 30 minutes 30 minutes south to 43 degrees 39 minutes south latitude and 113 degrees east to 153 degrees east longitude. Okay, so here already I told you, when you want to find out the location, only one parallel line and one vertical line is sufficient. But when you want to find out the area, okay, when you want to find out the area, so for that you have to use the two lines, two vertical lines as well as two horizontal lines. That means two latitudes and two longitudes we have to use. Suppose I want to find out the Australia. So this is the Australia region, okay, Australia continent. So where it is started, it is started with the, from this latitude and it is ended with the, this latitude. Okay, that means what, the area between the length between Australia is what, this line to this parallel line to this parallel line. Okay, and what is the width of Australia? So it is started with vertical here, vertical line, this vertical line too, and it is ended with this vertical line. Okay, so this total part we call as what, area. So you want to find out the extent or area is the same. Okay, you want to find out the extent. So for that you need them two parallel line. That means where it is started and where it is ended, and this side also where it is started and where it is ended. That means what, simply where the length start, where is the starting point in north side and where is the ending point in south side, or where is the starting point west side and where is the ending point in east side. So like that we have to calculate extension. So here they are given example also to you. So this is the latitudinal extension and longitudinal extents of Australia. For describing the extent of linear features like a river, road, etc., we need to consider the latitude and longitude for their terminal points. For example, the River Nile in Africa originates in Lake Victoria, flows north and meets the Mediterranean Sea near the city of Alexandria in Egypt. The location of Lake Victoria is 0 degrees 45 minutes 21 seconds south latitude and 33 degrees 26 minutes 18 seconds east longitude. Similarly, the location of Alexandria is 31 degrees 12 minutes north latitude and 29 degrees 55 minutes 07 seconds east longitude. Okay, so here they are giving the, simply they are explaining what, if you want to find out the any region, okay, that is when you want to find out the any area, so you can use the one parallel line and one vertical line. You want to find out the area of particular region, extent, so you have to use the two parallel lines and two vertical lines. So that is they were explaining. And let us use the graticule. Answer the following question about location and extent with the help of figure 2.3. So this is the figure 2.3 and this map is belongs to which country? This is the Brazil map. Which country map this is? Brazil map. Okay, so you are observing this map, you have to answer the questions. Which latitude and longitude define the location of the capital of Brazil? Brasilia. So how our country having the capital city like Delhi. So like that Brazil also having the capital city. So that capital city name is what? Brasilia. Okay, so what is the extension of latitude and longitudinal extension of this Brazil? Okay, so see here. So Brazil is located here. Okay, so where it is? So 10 degrees horizontal line is there and 20 degrees, what is the vertical line? So 50 degrees vertical line is there. So in this point having the Brasilia. So that we have to write. And next one, what would be the longitudinal extent of Brazil that spreads from 15 degrees 15 minutes north to 33 degrees 45 minutes south latitude? Okay, so what is the longitudinal extent? So where it is passes, see here. So Brazil is started from this point. Brazil is started from which side? It is started from this point. Okay, so that means near above 0 degrees, means we consider it is a 5. Okay, it is a 5 degrees. Okay, and it is where it is ended. It is ended in this region south side, that is 30 degrees, 33 degrees something. Okay, so here they are indicated with the 30. So more than 30, so that's why it is a more than 33 degrees. Okay, next one. In which hemispheres does the Brazil extend in the north south direction? So Brazil is located in which continent, which hemisphere? So that is a which hemisphere? Western hemisphere. Okay, where it is located? Western hemisphere. See here, Brazil is located in a South America continent. So South America continent is located in which hemisphere? This is a Western hemisphere. So what is the answer? Western hemisphere. And next one, in which hemisphere does Brazil extend in the east-west direction? Okay, so which hemisphere does Brazil extend in the east and west direction? So Brazil is not located in only one continent. Some part is located in Northern America and some part is located in Southern Hemisphere. Okay, so this question, this one answer is South America and this one answer is what? North America. Okay, which parallels and meridians should be used to describe the extent of river São Francisco? Okay, so in Brazil, we have the one river also. So that river name is São Francisco. Okay, so which latitude, which longitude we are using for finding the location of this area? So that is the question. So which one here? 10 degrees. So 10 degrees longitude as well as what is the longitude? 40 degrees. 40 degrees longitude. Okay, so 10 degrees and 40 degrees, so that both lines are meeting in this point now. So this point we call as a area of location of this particular So Francisco. And describe the location of Marjo Island using the graphical. Okay, so where is the Marjo Island? Here, this one. So Marjo Island is in which side it is located? It is in western side of the Brazil. Okay, see here. Here they are indicated W now. W means what? It is west side. So where it is indicated, this island, it is located in the west side of the Brazil. Okay, so this is the part one of this chapter. For the continuation of this chapter, you have to see part 2 video. Okay, you have any doubts, please write in comments. Okay, and please subscribe and share with your friends. Thank you.